Two engines among the many that Toyota has produced stand out. Both were developed in the early 1990s and went on to power some of the most recognizable Japanese automobiles ever produced. The 1JZ and 2JZ engines are the topic at hand. The inline six-cylinder 1JZ and 2JZ engines from Toyota are among the most recognizable engines the company has ever created, garnering more attention than the vehicles they were first used in. Adding a 1JZ or 2JZ to a Toyota with less power has become increasingly popular in recent years, and even riskier retrofits are being made to BMWs and some American vehicles. Both are good choices if you're considering an engine swap for your automobile, but many are perplexed as to what engine to pick. Both are equally iconic and similar in design, but the 2JZ differs from the 1JZ in many ways beyond displacement. Even though the technology behind them has been around for more than 30 years, they continue to be some of the most widely used engines in custom builds, such as the Dodge Charger with a 2JZ engine swap. Although the 1JZ and 2JZ have different displacements, the 1JZ has 2.5 liters and the 2JZ has 3.0, there are many other differences between these two renowned engines. Let's first understand their history. The Sora GT JZZ30, also known as the Lexus SC in other parts of the world, was the first vehicle to use the 1JZ engine after it was released. The top-tier turbocharged models, however, are what we'll be concentrating on. The 1JZ GTE actually resembles its predecessor, the 7M GTE, quite a bit, but without all of the problems that plagued it. It was essentially the 7M done right. The 2.5-litre, 4-valve per-cylinder 1JZ inline 6 engine has double overhead cams DOHC. It has an oversquare design given its 86mm 3.39 inches bar and 71.5mm 2.81 inches stroke measurements. An oversquare engine will typically be more rev happy than an undersquare one. Variable valve timing VVTi from Toyota was also added to later models. It has two parallel turbochargers in its 1JZ GTE configuration, which are fed by either a front mount or side mount air-to-air intercooler. As opposed to the normally aspirated versions 10:1, it has a reduced compression ratio of 8.5:1. The 1JZ GTE produced the advertised 280 horsepower at 6,200 rpm and 279 pound-feet at 2,400 rpm with a stock boost of 9 psi. The Toyota Chaser JZX100 is a popular four-door sleeper sedan and is one of the most notable vehicles powered by the 1JZ GTE. It can sprint from 0 to 62 miles per hour in about 5.6 seconds in stock trim. Toyota Chaser, Cressida JZX81, JZX90, JZX100, JZX110, Toyota Sora JZZ30, Toyota Super MK3 JZA70, but only in Australia and Japan, Toyota Verossa, Toyota Crown JZS170, and Toyota Mark II are some vehicles powered by the 1JZ GTE. The popularity of the 2JZ in high-horsepower builds is primarily due to the fact that it is one of the most over-engineered Japanese engines. Contrary to popular belief, the 2JZ and 1JZ are very similar. The main distinction is the displacement, which has increased from 2.5 to 3.0 litres from the 1JZ. The longer stroke of 86mm 3.39 inches enables this. The 2JZ has a square design, which means that the bore and stroke are equal, and the cylinder bore is the same as the 1JZ's 86mm 3.39 inches. This results in a better balance between low and high-end horsepower and torque. The 2JZ has a square design, which means that the bore and stroke are equal, and the cylinder bore is the same as the 1JZ's 86mm 3.39 inches. This results in a better balance between low and high-end horsepower and torque. The main distinction is the displacement, which has increased from 2.5 to 3.0 litres from the 1JZ. The longer stroke of 86mm 3.39 inches enables this. When compared to the 1JZ, this results in a wider torque band. The twin-turbo design of the 2JZ emphasizes this even more. The 2JZ has twin sequential turbos, as opposed to the 1JZ's parallel twin-turbo setup. The 2JZ has two turbochargers, whereas the 1JZ only has one turbo for every three cylinders. However, the second turbo spooled higher up in the rev range, providing a more continuous push, whereas the first turbo engaged at very low RPMs for that low-end torque. The powerful inline 6 can generate up to 330 horsepower at 5,600 RPM and 324 pound-feet at 4,800 RPM in its 2JZ GTE version. The most notable vehicle powered by this engine is the Toyota Supra MK4, which can reach 62 miles per hour in just 4.9 seconds. The Toyota Aristo JZS147, JZS161, available only in Japan, and Toyota Supra JZA80 are vehicles powered by the 2JZ GTE. Now to answer the initial question, which engine swap is best? A crucial point is that, in contrast to popular belief, the 1JZ and 2JZ are essentially equally powerful. You might also be surprised to learn that they react to upgrades very similarly. However, if a 1JZ and a 2JZ are both similarly modified and generate comparable power, the 2JZ will respond more quickly due to its larger displacement. With single turbo conversions, this will be even more obvious given that a single large turbo takes longer to spool than two smaller turbos. Engine displacement, turbocharger size, and maneuverability are all directly correlated. As a result, the 2JZ will be more responsive at similar power levels and modifications because it has more displacement power. In practice, the 1JZ's stock bottom end can safely handle 650 to 700 horsepower, while the 2JZ can handle 800. If we convert this into simple math, we can see that the bottom end of the 1JZ is capable of producing about 260 horsepower per liter, while the bottom end of the 2JZ is capable of producing about 266 horsepower per liter. It goes without saying that there are builds out there that produce far more horsepower than these figures. However, even today, their cast iron bottom ends are among the strongest ever created. Regarding applications, the 1JZ's more rev-happy nature makes it ideal for drift builds because maintaining a slide and making sharp transitions both depend on staying in the upper part of the rev range. Because of its shorter stroke, the 1JZ loves to run at high revs but has weak low-end torque. The turbocharger needs more time to spool when the stroke is shorter. The 2JZ, on the other hand, has both low-end torque and a wide torque band, almost resembling that of a large normally aspirated engine thanks to its longer stroke and sequential twin-turbo setup. Just this alone greatly increases its street use compliance. Strangely, the 2JZ is less dependable when maintained at high RPMs for an extended period of time due to the longer stroke. There are lots of parts and businesses that focus on these engines. The 1JZ is a little less expensive. When it comes to the construction of both of these engines, there is a clear trend. While most 2JZ builds are insane 10 or even 9 second drag cars, most 1JZ builds are drift cars. Both engines have advantages and disadvantages, but when used properly, they can deliver impressive numbers while retaining the majority of their fantastic reliability. So what would you pick between the two iconic engines? Let us know your thoughts in the comment box below. If you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.